What is multi-access edge computing? How's it different than regular edge computing? Hi, I'm Dan Kehn from IBM Cloud, and before I answer those questions, please click like and subscribe. Edge computing is about bringing compute capacity closer to where data is created to reduce response time and the load on back-end servers. Multi-access edge computing is the next logical step in edge computing for telco cloud. It brings compute capacity directly to network's edge, literally on the same infrastructure as the network itself. Let's go through it using an example. So we have, say, an image application that does image analysis. It communicates with the core network. That, in turn, works with the back-end server. For sake of discussion on that back-end server, let's assume we have a service called Image Analysis Service installed. Okay, this is a classical application design pattern. The user makes a request, it goes to a back-end server, it formulates a response, and returns to the end user. A round trip for that, including latency, might be on the order of 100 milliseconds. And that's perfectly fine for many applications, but let's assume we have a more demanding application. For example, one that does video. And it isn't using just one user that it wants to capture. It's capturing a crowd. Maybe it's used for security purposes, maybe it's used for threat analysis. Those are just some examples. What really drives us towards an edge computing solution are two things. First, there's a lot of data. Now, an HD video camera, that could stream as much as 6 megabits per second. The other thing is the real-time aspect. We need a real-time response. It would be difficult to send all that data back to the back-end server, process it, and return it in real-time. That's why we install edge servers closer to where the source of data is. So say, for example, we install some edge servers, and on those, we install the video analysis service. This really helps with our latency problem. We no longer have to send data across the network to a faraway server. It also helps with our data volume problem. We're no longer sending huge amounts of data across the network. Where multi-access edge computing comes into play is when we add a third element. Specifically, mobility. In the prior examples, we were assuming that these edge computers were in a fixed location. For example, at a retail location, providing a shopping experience, maybe an IoT device in a factory that's doing assembly. Those are examples where the edge computer location is known. In this case, for multi-access edge computing, it could be anywhere. We cannot predict where the edge computers might be located, so we install them on the network itself. So for example, we could have a radio access network and then install it at the base station, or we could install it at the data center for the network itself. This really drives latency to its absolute minimum, as little as 10 milliseconds. It also reduces the load on the back-end server for the enterprise. We could then repurpose that for something else. For example, we could do machine learning. So for example, say we do machine learning training, then we take that result and we give it to the video analysis service to improve the quality of its results. There's a couple other different benefits that are worth noting. Because this is running on the network's infrastructure, if there is a temporary outage between the back-end server and video analysis, it can continue to process. Thus, you have continuous operations. Finally, there is the ability to take advantage of radio access network data. For example, the radio access network would know where the location of the users are and could potentially predict where additional load will be required. This allows their network to be much more responsive to users' needs and being able to deploy capacity where it's going to be needed in the future.
Multi-access edge computing means communication service providers can bring compute capacity directly to your users no matter where or how they connect to the network. Thank you for watching. If you have questions, please drop us a line below. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, please like and subscribe.